Well, going back to one of our top stories now for more on the Senate's probe into the People's Initiative for Charter Change, we're now joined by Senator J.V. Ejercito. Senator, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program.
Yes, Carmina, good afternoon to you also.
Right. It's only the last day of January, yet it feels like we've lived through a year already because of everything that has happened in the past days. Let me start with Representatives Geraldine Roman and J.J. Suarez expressing their misgivings about the Senate inquiry that happened yesterday, calling it a circus and a waste of time. What do you say to that?
Well, first of all, Carmina, the belief that the people's will is most sovereign. No? People's initiative, if it's genuine, then we will respect. But we all know for a fact now, based on what really happened yesterday, that it's not really a people's initiative, but instead it's a politician's initiative. Hearing the testimonies, the members of the House, other politicians were really clearly involved in this activity. And my question yesterday to the PIRMA, which is the convener, leading convener of this drive, is that in the question, not on the people's initiative, it's supposed to be what the particular provisions that you want to amend, but what was reflected in the question was the mode of voting, no? Voting as one. So from there on, it's already flawed. And Carmina, also on record, they already have a timeline, no? The conveners of PIRMA and the politicians behind, they had the timeline, January 14 to be exact, to already pass the completed or the 3% that is needed of signatures. And Carmina, if you notice, we returned to session January 22. So from that, it's already there's doubtful, or we suspect that there was really a plan, a sinister plan, to really take out the Senate of the equation, no, in this activity, because we were on break. We were all caught by surprise. And if I may add also, Carmina, there was already a meeting between the Senate President Mig Zubiri, Speaker Martin Romualdez, in the presence of President Bongbong Marcos during the Van de Honor in January 5 to prevent a constitutional crisis brought about by this People's Initiative drive. And it was already agreed upon that the Senate would pass the resolution, the RBA 6, and then the House will just adopt it, no? So that we will end. But the House, and the understanding that the House also stops the PI drive, no? But they continued on. So we were, I think, they did not honor the agreement that was reached by the both leaders of houses in the presence of the president.
And there lies the problem, because they're saying even if there was that meeting that happened between both leaders of Congress and the president, the House of Representatives yesterday, through the persons of Congress Representatives Roman and Suarez, they're saying that they're out of it. This is the real people's will. Taong bayan daw po ang kumikilos dito, hindi naman sila.
Well, it was obvious yesterday, Carmina, during the proceedings, no, during the hearing, that the PIRMA group, no, the convener, really met with the House leaders, no, and they were coordinating. It came from their mouths that they were working or coordinating with the leaders of Congress. And sabi pa nga nila, hindi lang advisory, administratively also, no, that the House leaders were also involved. So
where does that statement put what the House Speaker said yesterday, that his role was merely advisory?
Well, it came from Mr. Noel Oñate already, the convener of PIRMA, that it's not only advisory but administrative also. So it did not come from anybody, but from the convener of PIRMA himself.
Now, they're also saying, the two representatives who held a press conference yesterday, they're saying this is already moot since COMELEC already suspended the process regarding this people's initiative. Is this enough reason for you to stop the inquiry? Because we're only on day one. Go ahead.
Well, actually, Carmina, based on the agreement between both leaders of houses and President Bongbong Marcos, we in the Senate continue our work. In fact, there will be a subcommittee that will be formed to hear already the amendments to the economic provisions or the RBH6 as agreed upon. Mm-hmm. So we will be continuing with our work and on the part of the agreement. So mm-hmm. My personal stand, we can only, they're asking for a ceasefire, but, we can only have a ceasefire as long as the PI, this PI, which is not genuine, would be put on hold or they put a stop to this. Because, Carmina, personally, I feel sad, I feel frustrated that, there are far bigger problems that we have to address, challenges that we have to surmount at this time. And it's all about timing. Chacha per se, PI is very divisive. You have now, it's hell broke loose already. No, early political bickerings is already hindering our drive for economic recovery and development. No, so that's my personal position that, we have to concentrate on these matters, food security, inflation, energy, prices of energy, infrastructure. These are the things that we should be working on at this time. Mm. Right now in the Senate, as we speak, we are having our hearing right now on economic zones that will chart the country's direction for creating jobs and opportunities by creating economic zones and infrastructure development, Carmina.
Given all that you said, Senator, do you think it's time for Senator Aimee Marcos to, halt the investigation, halt the inquiry into this so-called People's Initiative?
Well, my personal opinion, it doesn't reflect the Senate, but I'm hoping that there would be, if we could have, if we could simmer or cool down a bit, no, because this political bickerings is not doing the country any good. No, it doesn't give us a good perception internationally. We're trying to entice foreign direct investments, but because of this political bickerings, there's a perception of political instability, economic instability. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping that we will come up with a solution on how we can move forward. But Carmine, I'm hoping the House would honor the agreement. No, we will continue with.
Yeah, sorry to cut you there, Senator. So sila muna mauna, pero tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung investigation until and unless they halt whatever it is that they're planning, the committee will continue investigating the People's Initiative. Go ahead.
The way I speaking with the Senator Aimee Marcos, the way I it's not her statement, but see it is that she will only put a stop as long as there is a categorical statement that PI is really put on hold already, or they put a stop to this. Mm-hmm. No, Carmina, hindi isang tayo nagkagulo ng ganito. If they only honored the agreement in front of the president, no, mm-hmm. We will continue. We will already hear the proposed amendments and the economic provisions, and then they will adapt. Then we move forward. But what happened was, we were already scheduled to that, but the gathering of the signatures continued on. So they did. I think it's already on their part. The ball is on their part to put a stop. And I think that Senator Marcos, it will be. She's a different lady. Also, she's really a fighter. She will only stop with these hearings as long as there is already a categorical statement that that PI is dead. PI is already put on hold or stopped.
Okay, so there's that. She'll only do that once the lower house puts a stop to it. But the Senate also adopted a resolution, Senator, authorizing Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri to question the constitutionality of the People's Initiative. So it's like you want them to stop Okay, but then you're going ahead and questioning the constitutionality of it. Why will you still go through that process, given that you're also wanting things to simmer down and cool down a bit? Because as you said, it's really not looking good.
Well, Carmina, we have learned our lesson, no? Because after the January 5 meeting, we relaxed already, but they still pushed through. So we let our guards down, no? From that time on. So right now, not unless it is already concrete that PI is already dead, or they really put a stop to it, then we will continue to. The Senate will continue to exhaust all means, the legal, political, and we will continue with other networking and talking with other anti-Chacha groups until this activity is put a stop.
Mm-hmm. So, para po pang panakot ito sa kanila? Are you considering? Go ahead.
I think we just learned our lessons kasi nag-relax kami. We put our guards down. Mm. Now we will always have to guard ourselves. It's not, again, Carmina, let me be clear also that, you know, we are not fighting for the Senate's survival. The PI is not it's not only a conflict between the House of Representatives and the Senate. No, there's a lot of things at stake here, and that's what we want to inform the people, no, that there's a lot more at stake in here. Mm. So we are just being cautious right now that it doesn't happen again. No, we will probably lower down our guards as long as we are already 100% sure that PI is dead.
All right, Congressman Marcoleta, in yesterday's hearing, really very insistent about his reading of the Constitution, that both houses vote jointly on the matter, even when there were justices there expressing their complete opposite opinion on it. And then we just heard from the president, who had just arrived from Hanoi, saying that he sees this as a bicameral system, and therefore the vote should be separate. Do you think that this is enough to spell the end for this people's initiative?
Yes, Carmina, because our constitution, all the constitutions, prescribes that we have a bicameral system, so that the checks and balances will always be there. And even the president's legal counsel, Juan Ponce Enrile, also emphasized, no, during our meeting with the president, you know, that the bicameral system has to be respected, no? And that's why he said it's very important that both houses should vote separately. Mm-hmm. And doon nga pala magdududak na, Carmine, as I mentioned, in any people's initiative, if you propose an amendment, you should already ask the people what particular provisions that you want to be amended, whether political or economic. In this kind of PI, it's the manner of voting. Yung po yung tinatanong, no? Voting jointly or voting as one. So, from there on, and if you connect also that there was a timeline that until January 14 they already have to have all the signatures in and passed and verified. So talagang may ano rito eh. It's already suspect, no? While Congress was
but because the president already said that he sees this really as that. He was very explicit in saying it, vote separately. Tingin niyo ho ba ito na yung, I mean, will the House of Representatives get the message here?
I'm hoping that the president already made this statement, and I'm glad that he listened also to the legal luminaries. Probably also Justice Bersamin was there, Juan Ponce Enrile. And they have advised him well that, you know, we have to respect what's enshrined in our constitution, that, you know, the bicameral system to provide checks and balances should always be respected. Mm.
Finally, Senator, you know, there were are some analysts who are already saying that they need to hear more from the president, that the president should not appear to be a weak leader, because that is a going perception, that he should step in and be categorical in what he wants to happen. What else do you want to hear from the president, or do you think that statement is enough to get the message across?
Well, you know, Carmina, we are not obstructionists, as what some members of the House are portraying the Senate to be. We are open, in fact, for revisions on the Constitution, as long as we keep it on the economic provisions. No, we are wary of the political provisions, lifting of term limits, extending the terms. So, pag doon lang po, I think we are very amenable. And what Senator Grace in particular is asking the president to categorically state, you know, that, you know, you have to put a stop already to PI, and we will continue on with his wishes. He wants, really, in particular, he was particular that he really wants the economic, he wants amendments to the economic provisions alone.
But he said it already, and yet the message, the intended recipient, you know, they don't seem to get it, or they don't want to listen. So what language will the president use here?
I'm hoping that they already get the message and listen to the president, because I hope they realize, no, that this all brouhaha that's happening, again, as I mentioned, hell broke loose already. It's hitting the president already. No, all of these political bickerings, the attacks from former President Duterte, the other civil society groups. So I'm hoping that if we can only work together. They're asking for ceasefire, but as long as I'm hoping they follow what the president already has stated. You know that we have to. The voting should be separately and honor what has been agreed upon. Again, we propose the economic, we pass the economic provisions amendments, and then they just adopt, and then we continue on and move forward.
But then again, one has to ask, Senator, whatever happened to, you know, all the three branches of government being co-equal? I mean, here you are taking orders from the president and following what he wants, when you should be an independent institution.
Well, definitely, as you can see, Carmina, being the Senate has always been regarded as the last bastion of the, or one of the bastions of democracy, and we have stood our ground, no, against all odds, even in this issue. But I think the president is just what the president is doing now is to prevent a constitutional crisis that might take place because of all of this, because of this very divisive activity that is the PI and Chacha.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Senator J.V. Ejercito taking our Zoom call this noon. Thanks again for joining us. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Take care.